The Hoare triple for assignment to a simple variable, not an array element, for example, defines that assignment in terms of how one proves it correct. You will be surprised at its simplicity. Suppose we want to find the precondition under which execution of x becomes 2, terminates with 0 at most x, at most 4. Since the assignment is x becomes 2, the precondition is the postcondition, but with every occurrence of x replaced by 2. Since the precondition is equivalent to true, we can put that precondition in the beginning. Thus, in all initial states, execution of x becomes 2 terminates with 0 at most x at most 4. Note what we did. Because the assignment is x becomes 2, the precondition is the postcondition with every occurrence of x in the postcondition replaced by 2. Let's try another example. Since the assignment is x becomes x plus 1, the precondition is the postcondition, x at least 5, but with every occurrence of x in it replaced by x plus 1. And we can write this as x at least 4. This way of figuring out what the precondition is works for every assignment x becomes e to a simple variable x. To define this carefully, we introduce the notation r bracket x colon equal e close bracket to denote a copy of assertion r, but with each occurrence of x replaced by e. For example, in this use of the notation, the value of the expression is x times x at least 5, but with every occurrence of x replaced by x plus 1. We then define the assignment statement like this. The extra term is needed to eliminate cases where evaluation of E aborts, say by dividing by 0, or goes into an infinite loop. For example, in this Hoare triple, the statement x becomes 6 divided by 0 always aborts. It never terminates with y equal 5. And thus the precondition is false. Evaluation of 6 divided by 0 does not terminate normally. We take it for granted that in the programs we write, evaluation will terminate normally in order to simplify later discussions and to be able to write the definition in this way. Note, we can think of this as the definition of assignment to a simple variable, not in terms of how to execute the assignment, but in terms of how to prove it correct. That's neat. Here's another example. We want to find the precondition for the following sequence. Using the rule just given, we find the precondition of S becomes S plus K. Using the rule again, we find the precondition of K becomes K plus 1. We can simplify this precondition. To make it absolutely clear, we first split off the last term of the sum, and then subtract K plus 1 from both sides. So the precondition is S equal sum of m dot dot k. And we see that the assignments k become k plus 1, s become s plus k, leave the assertion s equals sum of m dot dot k true, while increasing k by 1. On the last page of the text version of this audio, there are two exercises for you to try. Please do them.